Medical Center. Really appreciate you spending some time. Have a great weekend, Nick.
Thank you as well, sir.
You bet. Thanks.
The Biogen conference held in Boston in February was already considered a super spreader event, and now researchers say the conference is linked to up to 300,000 COVID-19 cases worldwide. Scientists at Harvard and Mass General came up with that number after tracking the spread of two specific strains of the virus found in people who attended the conference. While most of the early cases linked to the Biogen conference were in Massachusetts, about 29% of total cases were actually found in Florida.
Well, New York City will shut down indoor dining beginning Monday. Governor Andrew Cuomo says hospitalizations and infection rates have not stabilized. With all the people in the city, indoor dining is just too big of a risk. Outdoor dining and takeout, though, will continue. And at least one Massachusetts lawmaker is calling for similar measures here. 26th District Representative Mike Connolly tweeting today, calling on the governor to shut down indoor dining, casinos, and also other non-essential indoor activities. Meanwhile, Rhode Island's economic pause has been extended for another week. Governor Gina Raimondo says it will now last through December 20th, next Sunday. That means the state's casinos, gyms, and other recreational facilities will remain closed at least until then. That pause took effect on November 30th. Governor Raimondo says unemployment benefits and relief for affected businesses will also be extended for another week.
So what is the safest way to form a COVID-19 bubble? Coming up, advice from a doctor on group gatherings.
But up next, leading the way, how Massachusetts, we've got a bug flying here, how Massachusetts is pushing back on claims of voter fraud in the 2020 election.
Stop and Shop helps you savor this season with Go Rewards. Earn points on just about every...